Does your business lack a consistent follow-up strategy when reaching out to leads in your CRM? Hi, my name is Zach Spader with Cornerstone Solutions. And today we're going to take a look at a new functionality in Zoho CRM called Cadences and how they can help you develop a consistent follow-up strategy for your leads. Let's take a look. Okay, so one of the things that really takes a business to the next level is developing a consistent strategy for moving people through your pipeline. So customers really, really appreciate a consistent follow-up strategy, and it will help you close more leads by being consistent. You may have different salespeople that have different philosophies. You may have people in different places in the country, and creating a consistent process or pattern for how you follow up with the leads that you get in is very, very, very important. And so before Cadences, there was a couple of different ways that you could do that in CRM. You could create blueprints or you could create workflows, things like that. But Cadences is really specifically developed for following up with records. Maybe it's a lead follow-up that you're doing, or maybe you're following up on a quote that you issued. Any record in the system where you have some kind of a follow-up process, the Cadences could really help your business. So what I'm going to do here, I'm in my CRM and I'm going to click on setup. And you can see under automation here, we have this new option called Cadences. I've already got one Cadence in the system. This is a manually enrolled Cadence. So this particular Cadence is going to be fired off when we manually select it. And I'll show you that in a little bit here. The second Cadence that I want to create is going to be based on a view that we're going to do. And so this is going to be the second one that we're going to create is more of a an automated Cadence. And so I'm going to go back to my lead module here, and I want to create a view for the records that what I want to enroll automatically in this Cadence. And so I'm going to click new custom view. We're going to call it Cadence 2. Make it really simple. We know exactly what this view is for. And then I'm going to do this based on the status. So we have lead status is, and let's base this on the pre-qualified. So we're going to click pre-qualified here. Okay, now that we have our view, we can go back into setup and go back to Cadences again. And we're going to create a new Cadence. It's going to be based on our lead module. We'll call it Cadence 2. Okay, this is where we select how we're going to enroll them. So this is what I was talking about. The first one that I did was a manually enrolled leads process. And then this one, we want to do leads in a custom view. And then I select the custom view, and I'm going to select this one that I just created, Cadence 2. And we're going to check the box for enroll new records when they're added to this view. Then we have a couple other options. We can select right away when they meet the criteria, or we can select after a few hours, few days. So like if you want to wait maybe a day before you enroll them in this Cadence, you can select, you know, after a few days, and then you can select the number of days that you want to enroll them in. So let's do that. Let's say after a few hours, and let's do 8 hours. That way, if let's say that we've just talked to them on the phone and we put them in the pre-qualified, then the Cadence doesn't start right away. It'll give us a couple hours before it starts. I click next here. And then we have a series of follow-ups, and we can create follow-ups in these different sections here. And so let's say follow-up one, we want to follow up with an email. And so let's assume that when we're pre-qualifying these leads that we're having a discussion with them on the phone, and then the 8 hour time period goes by, and we want to follow up with an email just, you know, saying, hey, it was great talking with you today. I'm really interested in moving forward with you. So let's create an email follow-up here. We're going to select who we want to send it out to, and then we select our template. And let's just select one that we already have in the system here. I don't know exactly what this one is, but we'll just select this one and where it's coming from, who it's going to, who who's replying to. We'll just save that. Okay. So we have our follow-up one here. And then let's say that 3 days later, we want to have a task for the person to follow up with another call. So let's say we have a call option here, but this isn't a this isn't really a scheduled call. This is just, hey, we want them to reach out. So I'm just going to create a task on this one. And so first thing that we have here is the option to select when we're going to do this. And so obviously, we don't want to do this immediately after we send out the previous email. We want to wait 3 days. And so let's select 3 days after the previous email is. And then you even have some options here as well. So you could wait until after they open the email or after they've replied to the email, things like that. We're just going to click send. We want to follow up 3 days after the email is sent. Follow-up call, and we want that to be due right away when the task gets created. And we're just going to leave the users blank. That'll automatically assign it to the record owner, and we'll notify them that that's being set up. Okay, so you can kind of see how these cadences are built. It's pretty easy. Just you can click on the little plus icons here to add additional actions in. So let's say that let's create an additional follow-up here. Let's create one more follow-up email that goes out. And let's say that we'll do this 7 days after the previous task is, and in this particular case, let's say that the task is completed. So once they complete the task of following up with the call, then we'll send an email 7 days later. So completed, and choose our recipient. Select our template here. Now let's create a new template for this one. Okay, and we'll add this new email to our cadence. Save that. Really easy. Really easy to create a follow-up series based on emails, calls, tasks, whatever your process is or whatever the process that you want to follow. Very easy to create, just a easy click of a button to create additional tasks and additional actions that you want within this cadence. And so then we'll go ahead and publish this. And this is basically just letting us know that this is going to start triggering this for people who are in this custom view immediately. So there was one kind of demo record that we had in there. So this would trigger this for this demo record that we had. So let's go ahead and publish this. And then if we go back to our leads module here, you can see that in the Cadence 2, we have our lead here that we have. And then if we go over and look at the timeline, you can see that we have the time here in which it was enrolled in the cadence. And so that was just a couple of seconds ago that we triggered that and it was enrolled. And we can even see this mail action, this email action is right here. So we can see that email action via the cadence already scheduled in our record here. So again, just to follow up, cadences are a really easy way for you to create a consistent follow-up methodology within your CRM so that no matter where your salespeople are or what their particular way of dealing with leads in the system is, you can, as a business, create a consistent follow-up procedure for leads or quotes or whatever record in the system that you want to create this for. Hopefully this has been helpful for you. Have a great day.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.